Howdy, 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 YouTube. This is Tolstoy Kafkatsky, still recovering from my horrible wound that I took on camera. No, I'm kidding. But yeah, this one is more about airsoft guns, and this isn't... It's not like something I'm going to do forever, but... Well, long story short, my brother saw my vid, and he saw me playing around with my faux gun, and... oh, by the way, some people asked about my Luger. It's a cap gun, you see, when you... From, like, the 50s. Back when you could make cap guns look like real guns, you would pull the trigger, and it would cause the hammer to come back, and then, you know, it would... snap. I think a lot of you know how, those kind of guns work. Anyway. So, anyway, my brother saw my little pistol there, and he said it... He thought they were neat, and he said, well, let's go take a look at the sporting goods, and we drove on down to, it's a store near us called Dick's. I know, it's called Dick's Sporting Good. I'm sorry, I don't mean to be immature, but you called it Dick's. Dick's. Okay, well, anyway, so we were there, and, like, you know, we had 15 minutes till closing, which was weird, because it was, like, 6 o'clock. I'm like, you close at 6:15? Anyway, and, we did a couple of some new guns. I think it's about the last airsoft I'm going to buy, because I'm not, like, into the sport. Obviously, I don't have any friends to shoot it with, but, you know, whatever. This is kind of cool. Anyway, gonna model some of the guns, and you know damn well that, doing that little action sequence with the music was so much fun for me, I'm actually going to end up doing it again, and I got something interesting for you guys, but, first let's just talk about the guns. First up is this piece of crap. I don't know if you can see that, it came with a nice little holster, but, regardless, it is still a piece of crap. It's loaded? No, the safety's on. Okay, this is a, camo Stinger or something like that. I don't know. It's like made by a company named Stinger, and it's the model is P9. I don't know what the hell that means. Anyway, and it's made, it's camouflage, camo collar, which is kind of, first of all, no one would want to make a gun camo, because if you drop it in this area, you would, like, or not in my area, but like in the area you would obviously be using it, i.e. desert or Iraq or whatever like that, it would blend in with the ground you dropped it into, so that's really stupid as hell. But besides that, take a look at the features. The clip eject is actually a secondary trigger, kind of like that right there. And you pull that down, and there you go. And then this here is the thingy-do-wah, the magazine. And the this magazine's interesting, and it's pure in the sense that all you have to do to load it is, first of all, you actually just pour a good amount of BBs into the back. And you close it up, and then whenever you want to reload it, you just pull the spring all the way down and give it a shake. And it reloads. And there you go. Unfortunately, it loads, as you can see, kind of awkwardly, and if you put, like, different types of... Yeah, there BBs in there. There you go. It's that white one. It just gets jammed. So... Anyway, this thing has problems because it gets jammed a lot. I don't know if there's one in the... Nope. Good. This thing gets jammed cocking. That's the thing. That's the problem with it. It often... There you go. It's jammed. There's only one way to unjam it, but it works. It just slam it against something, which, you know. Anyway, this thing, though, it is a higher-powered pistol. I don't know how that's possible. I guess it just has better spring action, but I let my brother shoot me with this, and this one hurt a bit more. Like, through the coat, it still stung. You know, I was wearing a coat for padding, and I was... But then again, he was a little closer. Still, though, not terrible, but I don't care who says it. It still hurts when you get shot. I guess it's kind of fun. It's kind of exhilarating, but, you know, whatever. But I'd rather be the one shooting than the one getting shot. Not always. All right. Up to what I got. I kept looking around for a battery-operated semi-automatic pistol, but couldn't find one. I could find gas-powered, but CO2 cartridges, first of all, public safety, or public announcement, CO2 cartridges are expensive and wasteful because they have to produce little steel, you know, cartridges to load into your gun. They're, I would imagine, hard to handle, and of course, bad for the environment. So I was looking for battery-operated, and I could only find one battery-operated, pretty cheap. It was like $29, and it was actually an SMG. The, what's the word, stereotypical Uzi, and as you can see down here at the bottom, you have a little battery slot, which you slide forward or backward, I can't remember, slide backward, there you go, slide backward, then you load your batteries in like so, there you go, then to fire, you cannot just pull the trigger, but you must push the safety forward and then pull the trigger. Part of the sight up here is actually where you load this mother, and you pull it open like that, and there you go. You just like load BBs right into there, and it just pulls it like from a main chamber, and you can, believe it or not, you can lay out some pretty good rounds with this. I set up some paper targets, and I could blow a lot of holes in them, which was kind of fun, but of course, nothing compared to what the Grand Poobah my brother bought with his less limited paycheck. a, let's see, R72 pulse rifle. Oh boy. This thing is a mother. And let me tell you, you know how they say that you don't need to know how to aim if you have an automatic? Wow, is it true. This thing has so many switches and shit, I have no idea what all of it's for. But let me tell you, it doesn't take much to, you know how to figure it out. You've got a full switch here that has three modes. This is safe mode. This is semi-auto. It was loaded. Wow. Okay. Well, that should teach you something. Okay. So anyway, this was the clip that it came with anyway, and you gotta load the clip in like, that was safety. Shit. Gotta load the clip in kind of at an odd angle, which is the only problem with it. And it's hard to figure out which way it's facing. I forget which way you gotta, yeah, it's like... There you go. And she's in. Safety on. The only problem with this is you often have the tendency to want to, screw with the battery pack down there. And, I don't know if you can see that, but I accidentally, Oh, well, stuck on there pretty good now. So, yeah, you can use that. The aiming is very precise and everything. I'm going to test this out on some stuff and do like another neat little action sequence. And before you even ask, yes, it is a new trench coat. I saw it at Value City for like $23, if you can believe that. So, yeah.
Yes.